Our topic today is we're talking about mental health services. You may have seen that on our Facebook page. And so talk to us about the sort of what kind of services are available for people right your age, going to university or your friends. What kind of services are available?
About, you know, how to treat people with mental diseases, like, you know, things that is going on with their heads and stuff.
Right.
Like that? Oh, mm-hmm. I see.
Yes.
So, as far as I know, in Indonesia, they treat people, you know, we have some kinds of asylum and stuff, but as for the treatment, I believe that we are still lacking if we compare to other Asian countries like Singapore and also Malaysia, because these days, Indonesian government is currently concentrating more in delivering the needs to overcome the physical diseases instead of the mental. Mm-hmm. You know, there are just a slight number of asylum here in Jakarta to treat those people with mental diseases, as far as I'm concerned with it.
So do you think that's more cultural or is that more economic based?
I believe that it's more economic based because here in Indonesia, you know, the growth number of, you know, people who are having mental diseases compared with people with physical diseases are quite large. You know, the number of differences is quite large. That's why the government is concentrating more towards people with physical diseases, like, you know, kids with with hydrocephalus, you know, hydrocephalus, and, you know, with other diseases as well, instead of, you know, thinking how to overcome the mental disease, as far as I know about it till now.
And what about at your university? Because I know in American universities, this has been a story this last few years, that American universities in their health centers are starting to offer more counseling for students who have stress or depression or other emotional disorders. And what about in your school?
Are we talking about, you know, I'm sorry, but the Columbine massacre, things like that?
Well, not even that extreme.
No.
Any college has students who are stressed out about their classes, their exams, their teachers, their relationships.
In my campus name is Venus University, if you ever heard of it.
Oh, I absolutely. You have a very strong, you have an English club there.
Okay. Talking about the counseling stuff, we actually have a part, you know, I don't know a club or what, but it's called Student Advisory Center, who can help, you know, students who are feeling stressed with their assignments, with their college work, and, you know, they help them with counseling, you know, whenever the students need the help to come and to overcome the problem, they just come to SAC or Student Advisory Center, and the people help them to talk through them with it.
Let me ask you this. Is it encouraged or are students worried about going there? Any stigma attached to it?
You know, it's a common thing when we don't want to show our vulnerability to other people, right? Because maybe our friends will think, okay, he or she is depressed, and it's a bad public image, which is why the SAC itself is not regularly visited somehow, but there are still some of my friends who come there and try to have a counseling session with the people there, you know, to talk things out.
I know in the United States there have been a lot of stories about universities are expanding their mental health services for students who face depression or stress, that is the university. How about in China? No? Like if you at your university felt the need to talk to a counselor, would there be one there?
I never heard of that in China.
About stress and those kind of illnesses, maybe people feel lately that they have such problems when they get down, when they go to a hospital. When, you know, psychological illnesses affect their body.
Then they're addressed. Well, it makes sense. When they're physically manifested, then they're addressed in your country. But is it done more internally within the family structure? Mm-hmm. Maybe discuss it with parents, with children.
That depends on your character. I mean, mm-hmm. your personality. Mm-hmm. If you are open or not open person, if you are calm or you prefer to talk about anything you is happening to you. So if you are an open person, it's easy to cure or to deal with this problem. But if you are not used to talk about these matter, I mean, care about yourself by your own, not share your problems with others, that would be so difficult to you.
So it sounds like maybe it's more for cultural reasons that people don't seek professional treatment. It's more for cultural reasons than for other reasons. Is that what you're saying?
Yes, I think this is the main factor for this.
And
knowledge.
Do you find that people don't discuss it openly amongst themselves because they're embarrassed or...
is a stigma?
Yes.
People might think less of them. Is that the concern?
You know, people usually try to even hide this part of their personality. I mean, here people maybe look at you if you have some problems in psychology. They look at you like crazy or you are not normal or so. You try to hide this to not affect your reputation.
Oh.
To...
Wow.
It's a strange right now.